Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can swap a tooltip on a visual. Stay tuned. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, swapping tooltips. It's kind of like that. We are going to switch out the actual tooltip, but there is a caveat to it. It's using the combination of bookmarks, selections, and buttons. I've been on a kick on that lately. Full credit for this goes to Chris Hamill. He is on the Power BI Cat team. He and I have been talking a bit about things you can do with bookmarks, and this was one of the things that came out of it. Check out his blog post on this. I have that in the description below. And, you know, he asked me to make a video on it. So here we are. Enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my machine and take a look at this. So I've got a visual here, and when I hover over it, I have a report page tooltip already set up. What I want to do is I want to give the viewer of the report an option of what they want to see. And so in this case, I'll refer to what you're looking at right now as the fancy tooltip. And what I want to do is I want to use buttons to toggle between that selection. You don't necessarily have to do this with a button. You could do it with a slicer, but in this case, I want to use it as a button to make it more of like an app-like experience. And so the idea here is when I hit simple, it'll switch the tooltip to something else. And when I hit fancy, you will see this item. So how do we do this? The first thing I need to do is I need to have a disconnected table to actually handle the state of where we're at. So let's get that created. I'm going to come up to the ribbon and hit enter data. And I'm just going to call this status. And I'm going to have two values in here. I'm going to have 0 and 1. Call it slicer status. I'm just going to load that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a slicer on this page. We're going to end up hiding this slicer, so it doesn't need to be fancy, doesn't need to match our theme or anything like that. Make a list, and I'm going to select 0 for the value. So now I've got this, and this will toggle between 0 and 1. This is the state of the tooltip that will be displayed. 0 is going to be simple, 1 is going to be fancy. Easy peasy. Next, what we want to do is we want to actually head over to the tooltip page, and we're going to bring up our friends the bookmarks and selections tabs. And also we're gonna want sync slicers as well. So now what I wanna do here, go back to the overview page. We're gonna copy the slicer visual. Just doing a control C after selecting it, go back to the tooltip page, and we're gonna paste it into our tooltip. Now, one thing that's gonna happen when you do this is gonna say, do you wanna do sync slicers or not do sync slicers? You have to choose sync here. We want the slicers on the tooltip page and the overview page to do the same thing. So if I switch it on one, it switches the other. So let's go ahead and do sync. So now we've got a sync slicer. We're gonna sync it between the overview page and the tooltip page. So both of those will be selected because that's where they are. And technically I can hide them at this point. It doesn't matter if they're there or not. I can hide them on the selection page. It's all good. Just the fact that it's there is what we want. Now, what we need to do is actually create the bookmarks. In this case, I actually want to show the slicer. This is going to be the fancy page. I need to select one and then hide it. So this will be the state of what we want when we're on fancy. Then I'm going to select all the visuals and I'm going to hit add bookmark. We're going to call it fancy. So now what I want to do is hit on the ellipsis of the bookmark. We're going to uncheck current page. What I don't want to do is when I hit this bookmark, I don't want it to move to the tooltip page. If you remember, I did a video on just mastering bookmarks and I talked about the different states. Current page on a bookmark means it's going to go to that page. I don't want that to happen for the tooltip. So we definitely need to uncheck current page so we stay on the overview page. All we're doing is swapping the visuals on the tooltip. Next, what I want to do is on the ellipsis, I want to do selected visuals just because that's a best practice. So I'm just going to have all the selected visuals. Everything's good. We're going to swap it. The other thing you'll notice, I made the data check present. I'm not unchecking that because this will maintain the slicer state. And remember, we changed it to 1, meaning fancy. So when we switch the bookmarks, it's going to switch the slicer state. So there we are. We've got our fancy tooltip. So now I'm going to swap this out. I've got a group here for my fancy visuals. I'm going to hide that. I'm going to bring in just a simple card visual, right? Let's undo slicer, change it to a 0, hide the slicer again, go to select all the visuals. We're going to add a new bookmark called simple tooltip. Same thing here. Uncheck current page, change it to selected visuals, and we are good to go. So now if I change the tooltip, looks good. We're done with the sync slicer tab. Now let's go back to our overview page. I'm going to go ahead and collapse these two. Actually, let's go back to bookmarks real quick just to show you the power of the sync slicer. If I switch between these visuals, watch the slicer state. Simple as 0, fancy as one. It's changing the slicer on this page because of the sync slicer. So they're gonna stay in sync on both pages, which is amazing. So now you're asking, why do we care about that? Let me show you on the overview page. I'm gonna actually hide the slicer. It's working. I don't care about it right now. I'm gonna choose the simple. Now what I wanna do is on the fill, I wanna give some indication of which one we're actually on. So on the fill, I'm gonna come down to the FX button. This is for conditional formatting. And I'm gonna change this to rules. I'm gonna change it to the slicer status page or the table on the status column. And I'm gonna say, if it's a zero, update the color of the fill. Right now we're on the fancy tooltip. So I'm gonna do the same thing on the fancy. So we're gonna say fill, conditional formatting. We're gonna do rules, slicer status, status. We're going to say if it's one, then we're going to change the color. So remember, one is fancy, zero is simple, and bam, now fancy's got a background on it. And if I control click to simple, nothing happens. Why didn't anything happen? Missing the most important step. We have to hook up the bookmarks. That's not switching anything yet. Let's do that. Come down to action. Going to turn it on, change it to bookmark, and then we're going to change it. Right now we're on simple. So we want simple tooltip. Choose the fancy button, action, bookmark, and fancy. So now what we're doing is we're saying if you click on the button, it's going to perform this action of switching or toggling the bookmarks. And so now I can do simple. Notice the background changes. And if I come down and hover over it, I get my little card visual. If I go back to fancy, I now have my fancy tooltip and we've got our background. So this does let you actually play around with what's displayed in the tooltip. It doesn't let you actually switch the tooltip page selection on the actual visual. That's not possible right now in terms of the actions and being able to do that. But this does give you flexibility in terms of actually changing what you want to display from a tooltip. And it's a kind of a cool technique if that's something you want to implement in your report. All right, what do you think? Was this bananas? I love the combinations of bookmarks, selections, and buttons. And you can just do amazing, powerful things from an application-like experience that really take your report to the next level. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.